get ready for the second quarter.
And you kind of feel like the Raiders let them off the hook there a little bit that first quarter. Started the first drive on their third, on the Taylorville 30, fumbled it away, and then drove down to the 11 on their second possession and couldn't get the first down to the touchdown, turned it over on down. So Taylorville is hanging in there, and right now they got a little drive going on their own.
And you got a second and 15 situation here. They've got Peters flanked here to the near side. Kreitzel flank out to the left side. Number 23 is Nick Gant. They come out of a power eye formation. Trulock, Lincoln wants to blitz. Trulock keeps it on the right side, and he's grabbed by the ankles. Nice tackle there for Lincoln. Trying to pick up who that was. It was Connor Schmidt, number 4. He's a junior, 5'7", 156 pounder. He made a nice tackle. Trulock went down at the 31-yard line. So now a third down situation, third and 14 for the Taylorville Tornadoes.
Anytime you face the option when you're on defense, you know, you've got somebody assigned to the quarterback, the pitch man, and the running back, and everybody's got to do their assignment to stop the option offense.
Hayden in the slot. Trulock rolls it. Good pressure there. Nice pressure. Who was that own goal for Lincoln?
Slater.
Tremendous pressure by Zach Slater on the quarterback, Trulock, and now it's going to be fourth and 15, and they're going to have to punt away into the wind to the north.
I guess the results will be a little different than the first punt, but yeah, you're right, Bob. Great pressure didn't give him a chance to roll out and find any open receivers, and he just threw it into the ground again.
Slater, a good all-around athlete. He's a good wrestler, too, and he showed his speed right there. And now the Tornado is going to have to punt it away. Logan Armbruster's back there. And here's the boot, and the boot's a pretty good kick, and it's gonna, they're gonna let it go. Dane Eimer let it go. And now it's gonna be downed by number 23. That is Gant for the Tornadoes. And they down it at the 27-yard line.
Well, that was a pretty good punt let's see, that was about 32, 32, 40. That was over a 40-yard punt into the wind. They got a nice roll, and the Raiders got away from it.
Yeah, good spy roll on that. So first and 10 for the Tornadoes. For the Rail Splitters at the 27-yard line. I forgot where that was at.
That was officially a 42-yard punt.
Nice to come up under center. There's a lot of Don Rickles up here. Handoff, Cruz. Cruz stood up at about the 29-yard line.
The Raiders need to be patient on offense and just get a drive going again like they did in the second possession in the first quarter.
Just short of the 30-yard line goes Andy Cruz. Bisinger's got the play from Coach Andy McDonald. Coach Joe Ryan along the sidelines with Coach McDonald. Evan Shirley back in there, wide out here on the near side. Man in motion, Slater's got it. Slater's stacked up right at the line of scrimmage. He didn't get much out of that one.
Yeah, he might even lost a little, but you know, we said in the pregame, Bob, that Taylorville has always been known as a pretty good, tough, hard-nosed defensive team, and they're good tacklers, and that was a good example of it right there. One man grabbed him and just held on to him, wouldn't let him go get around the corner and get loose.
You're right, Coach. They keep plugging all the holes tonight. Third and 7 for the Rail Splitters. Ball at the 29-yard line. He lost a yard there.
With the wind at their back right now, the Raiders may be prone to throw the ball in this situation.
Garrett Cooper now in there at one of the wing backs. Slater goes in motion, and they hand it off to Cooper. Cooper's got running room and a first down. Garrett Cooper came into the football game, and he picks up a first down. He got a lot of running chances early in the season. We've used him mostly on defense, but Cooper came in there out of nowhere. Came across field, got some good blocking, and got the ball down to the 40 with some good speed.
sealed the lineman and the linebacker to the inside, and he got off at a left tackle. And as you said, Bob, he just showed some great speed. As soon as he got to past the first down marker, he hit a wall and went down, but not before he picked up 11 yards.
Bisinger up under center, first and 10. Slater goes in motion. They pitch it to Slater around the right side. He's up to the line of scrimmage, and he's drugged down. Knocked the sticks down on the far side of the field. Slater ran all the way across the field, but he was taken down right at the line of scrimmage.
It's hard to see from our position up here, Bob, but he might have been better served if he'd have turned that up there before he tried to string it out. Defense did a nice job for Taylorville stringing that out all the way to the sideline, not letting him turn upfield. And if he had turned up sooner, he might have picked up a few.
You're right, Ken. It's usually his nature who'd cut it up earlier, but he must have saw a wall there, purple and white, and he just didn't do it. So it's going to be second and 10 for the Rail Splitters. Reisinger waits for the snap. He's got it. Hands off Cruz. Cruz on his feet. He's got 5 yards out of it. And the Cruz gets hit about 3 yards after the line of scrimmage, and then he just bowls his way for another 2 yards down to the 40, up to the 45-yard line of Lincoln.
It almost looked like he got a little additional push from behind by somebody, Bob, because he had about three and then all of a sudden lurched forward for a couple extra.
Well, as Lincoln's concerned, this is two down territory. They'll just keep rolling right here. Shirley to the near side. Armbruster stays in tight. Man in motion, Slater. Bisinger rolls out to his left. He's got pressure, stays on his feet, and he's knocked down for a loss. Back at about the 39-yard line, a 6-yard loss for the Rail Splitters.
Yeah, that was actually a loss 5, but you're right, Bob. He just didn't have much chance. He rolled to his left, and there was some penetration by the defense, and they were right on him, and he didn't have time to even look for a receiver.
Jordan Gesner, Anthony Cannon, Connor Schmidt check in for the Rail Splitters. Andy Cruz going to have to punt it away. Long snap by Slater to Cruz. Cruz boots it away. Nice block there by Leisinger. And the football is going to go out of bounds. And let's see, what are they going to spot it at? 21-yard line. Cruz kicked it out of bounds.
Yeah, probably not as much out of it as you'd like to with the wind behind you, but you know, last week they had one block, so they're probably happy just to get that one off.
They call it the 28-yard line, so it'll be Taylorville first and 10 at their own 28-yard line. Clock stops at 7:28 left in the first half. No score on the board as Seth Trulock, the quarterback for the Tornadoes, checks in. He goes to the sideline to get the play from head coach Jeb Odom. Odom, back in his day, a good all-around athlete for Taylorville.
Yeah, you're one of the young head coaches here in the conference now, him and Coach Andy McDonald.
Trulock again looks to the sideline. Now he looks to his running backs, comes up under center. First and 10 for Trulock and the Tornadoes. Gant goes in motion. They throw it out and it's left to Gant. He's got it, and it looks like it was Cooper there for the Whalers. On the tackle, Garrett Cooper, the outside linebacker. Senior Garrett Cooper had a nice running play when the Whalers had the ball. Now he picks up a very nice tackle for a loss for the Tornadoes back at the 24-yard line, a 5-yard loss. Compliments to Garrett Cooper.
And that was a live ball. That was a backward throw. So the receiver, he just kind of bobbled a little bit. It was a live ball. But you're right, Bob. Cooper came up and stopped him for a 4-yard loss on the play.
Cooper's the outside linebacker on the right side. Nick Cameron on the left side. The inside linebackers are Connor Schmidt and Zach Slater. And the middle linebacker's Andy Cruz. Up on that front line, the nose guard's Brandon Aper. And the defensive ends are Sawyer Conrady and Riley Reed. Second and 15 for the Tornadoes. As Trulock surveys the line of scrimmage, using his full 25 seconds. And now it looks like it's going to be a timeout for Taylorville. Timeout Taylorville on the field with 6:28 left in the first half. No score. Lincoln and Taylorville here on a senior night from Hamlin Field. We'll be back after this message. Bob Uber and Coach Ken Schweitzer back here at Hamlin Field on senior night. And it's going to be second and 15 for Taylorville at their own 24-yard line. Coach Odom didn't like what he saw and he called a timeout.
Yeah, that's the second timeout here in the first half, Bob. But you're right, there was something amiss there. There's some personnel indecision on the play call. But it's a second and 14 for them. And as we were just talking during the break there, Lincoln needs to get the possession back somehow and get on the board. I hate to see the game go 0-0 this long.
Taylorville comes up to the line of scrimmage now. Number 51 is the center, Josh Hadigan. Hadigan will snap it to Trulock. Chulak gives the call, and he wants to throw. He's going to throw it right up the middle, and he's got his man for a first down. Tackle. Chulak threw the first down. That was Eimer on the tackle for Lincoln.
That was a 20-yard pickup, and he was open. The Raiders had a man there covering him and made the tackle right after the catch, but they made a nice throw and catch for the first down.
Up to the Taylorville 44-yard line, and here come the Tornadoes now. Chulak looks along the line of scrimmage. Takes his time, now he comes up under center. Man in motion, and Chulak's going to keep it, and he's knocked down at the 45-yard line.
I think we're going to have a procedure penalty against the Tornadoes.
Against the Tornadoes, as Coach told you. And they'll take the football back to the 39-yard line. 6:04 left in the first half, no score. First and 15 now for the Taylorville Tornado. Chulak goes to the sideline, talks to head coach Jeb Odom. Now he's back into the huddle. Raider defense waits. The defensive backs are Jacob Summers and Logan Armbruster. The safety is Dane Eimer. Kreitz here to the near side, covered by Logan Armbruster. Now Chulak goes up. Now he hands off for, no, he keeps it. Stays on his feet, and he gets about 6 yards out of it. Down to the 45-yard line he goes. Off the bottom, Chulak on the carry to the up to his own 45-yard line.
And that was the option. He kept the ball. They got back just about what they lost on the penalty, but the Raiders did a pretty decent job finding the quarterback, finding the ball, and making the tackle.
So second and 9 now for Taylorville as Chulak comes back into the huddle. Chulak's a junior, 5'10", 163-pounder. Blake Peters split here to the near side. Chulak now comes up under center. And, ooh, the Railers are all over it. They pitch it outside, and he's finally knocked down. That was Matt Hayden. Hayden, a running back, 6'1", 160.
They picked up a couple yards on him, Bob, but you're right. The Raiders defense got in the backfield and stopped the initial play, and then they did really pitch it and came up and on the outside and did a good job defensively. So good defense all the way around.
So now it's going to be 3rd and 7 at the 47. 4:27 left for the first half. Still no score in the football game. Kreitz here to the near side. Peters flank to the left. Chulak looks along the left side. Now he comes up under center. Raiders want a blitz. Chulak's got it. Throws it up ahead. It is caught. That was Cody Kreitz, a senior. Six-footer. Gets the first down. Kreitz on a nice catch. And he's down to the Lincoln 40-yard line.
Well, the wideout, you know, the wideout, he's pretty much open by a lineman there. The Lincoln defensive back was playing even with him, and so he just slanted straight inside, and he was open from the get-go, and the quarterback did a nice job of hitting him with it and picked up the first down into Lincoln territory.
Chulak's got the play. Kreitz this time splits wide to the left. Peters to the near side. In the slot, that's Hayden. Out of that eye now comes Chulak. Chulak waits for the snap. Man in motion is Gant. Gant's got the pitch to the outside. He's up to the line of scrimmage. Looks for running room. He's got 5. He's got a first down, and he's finally knocked down. And another first down for Taylorville. That was Nick Gant. He's a senior, 6 foot, 173-pound speedster. Down to the 28-yard line of Lincoln.
And the other thing he got on that play was some great blocking. All of his blockers were locking up with Lincoln defenders, and we couldn't shed the blocks. It gave him some running room. As you said, Bob, picked up another first down.
So it'll be first and 10 for the Taylorville Tornadoes with 3:32 left in the first half. No score. Taylorville down to the 27-yard line as Seth Chulak, the junior, gets ready to go up under center. Railers stay back. Didn't look like we're going to blitz. Man in motion. Chulak keeps it, dives up ahead, and he stopped at the 25-yard line after about a 2-yard pickup. I want to thank all our fine sponsors. I want to thank all our listeners out in California for listening to us on the telephone and online.
I'm sure there's several.
I don't think he heard that. So it'll be 2nd and 8.
Well, listen, you know, the Tornadoes are threatening now, Bob, into Lincoln territory for the first time tonight, down to the 25. They got a second and long, and we're down inside 3 minutes here in the second quarter, but big time for Lincoln defense to step up.
2:50 left for the first half. Trulock. Lincoln wants to blitz. Rolls out to the right. He keeps it. Now he pitches it. Boom! Good job there. Running back saw that coming and he just went down.
Umbrischer came out and really challenged him there in the backfield and stopped him for virtually no gain, maybe a loss of a yard.
Gant said, man, I see the city of New Orleans coming, and he just went down to the turf before he even got hit.
And Umbrischer showed some great speed coming up from the secondary position. He read the play, and they pitched it to the outside, and that's what you got to do on that option on the pitches. You got to fly up from the secondary.
Now it's third and eight, 2:14 on the first half clock. Trulock's got to run all the way across the field into the huddle from his coach, Jeb Odom. Kreitz to the right side, Peters to the left. Hayden in the backfield. Trulock up under center. He's going to keep it. Wants to throw up ahead. Pick that. He's got it. We picked it off. It's at the one-yard line. Lincoln picked it off at the one-yard line. I think that's Eimer. Dane Eimer on the interception for Lincoln. Yeah, it was Dane Eimer.
And they pull him into the end zone, but unfortunately they're going to mark him that way. Caught it, I think, on about the two-yard line. So the Raiders are going to start on their own two with under 2 minutes to go. And the key here is not to make any mistakes and get that ball out from under your own goalpost.
Dane Eimer's a junior, wears the number 31.
Taylor only has one timeout remaining, so the Raiders, if they can just hold on to the ball and dig, go forward, they'll be able to run out the clock.
Man in motion, they hand it off. That's got to be Cruz out of that mess. Cruz is just taking the whole student body down to the 5 yard line. Andy Cruz from the old Pulaski Street gang, a descendant.
He picked up three tough yards there, and I don't know how daring Coach McDonald is. This might be a point. Oh, well, we got a minute 20 to go. They're not expecting a throw from here with the wind behind you. You might want to take a shot at it.
Reisinger looks along the line of scrimmage. Now he comes up under center. And I think that's Cruz again. Cruz will just drag them all with him again.
Just hang on to the ball.
Andy Cruz comes from tough stock, and he gets another 2 yards.
Trying to see if that was him getting up from the pines. Hard to see. Yeah, I think you're right.
I think that was one of those tough guys from Pulaski Street. Back in the 50s, there was 100 kids from Cruz's house down to Butler Street on Pulaski Street. They had a full starting lineup for a baseball team every day. And now Lincoln's going to take a timeout with 47 seconds left in the first half. We'll be back after this match. Bobby Derber and Coach Ken Schweitzer are back here on senior night at Hanlon Field. Lincoln called a timeout with a third and four here with only 47 seconds left in the first half. Coach McDonald's still down in there in the huddle talking to him, and maybe we're just going to go all the way.
That'd be great, but you know, the odds are not in your favor to do that at this position when you're on your own 9 yard line. As we said earlier, Taylorville hits pretty hard. You just don't want to lose control of the ball. Don't want to cough it up here. So I would think they'd take the conservative way and try to get the first down and then run out the clock.
Third and four. Lincoln in the home greens. Leisinger up under center. Man in motion. They give it off to Cruz again. And Cruz stays on his feet down to the 15-yard line. And he's got a first down.
It's a 6 yard pickup and the first down, as you said, Bob. And now the Raiders will be able to run out the clock here and get us to halftime.
Andy Cruz on the last three runs. Leisinger's got another play. Clock keeps moving. Shirley flanked to the left, Armbruster to the right. Leisinger comes up under center. Man in motion. Leisinger hands it off, and that is Schlater, and they run him out of bounds, but he gets another first down. 16 seconds. Zach Schlater. The Raiders keep pushing it down the field. Only 16 seconds left. The clock stopped as they went out of bounds.
got 11 yard pickup on that play. He's unofficially has 48 yards here on 8 carries in the first half.
Taylor's come to the line of scrimmage. 16 seconds left on the clock. They've got a first and 10. Eisinger comes up under center. Slater in motion. And they hand it off. I think that's Cooper. And he was hog-tied and thrown down. No penalty on the play. Garrett Cooper coming out of the backfield. And that's going to run the clock out. Cooper went down across the 28-yard line. Now they're going to stop the clock with 3 seconds. Coach McDonald called a timeout with 3 seconds left here in the first half. Football after Cooper's runs down just across the 28-yard line. So we'll take a 30-second timeout. We'll be Bob Gerber and Coach Ken Schweitzer back here at Hanlon Field on senior night. And Coach McDonald opted to take a timeout with 3.4 seconds left, and he's going to keep the Rotors rolling down the football field here right up until the end.
Yeah, maybe they've got some trick play. I don't know if he's inclined to try something here. You never know. Needs 71 yards to the end zone.
Leisinger waits for the snap. He's got it. He's back to throw. He's got time. He's going to throw it deep along the sideline to Armbruster. And it looks like it was picked off, and it was. Taylorville picked it off, but that's the end of the first half with the score. Lincoln Rail Splitter 0, Taylorville Tornado 0. We'll be back after these messages.